Namaste. Welcome to this very delicious, sweet practice of Yin Yoga. We're going through a few poses, breathing deep, relaxing deep, and just nourishing from within. Hope you have a yoga mat, maybe two blocks, because this is what we need for the practice. And beyond that, we start in downward facing dog. Just take a few moments here to settle in. Very naturally breathe in and out. If you want, you can as well sigh it out. Letting go of all distractions. Another inhale. Good. From here, lower your knees into tabletop. Bring back your left leg. Lower your left forearm. And then straighten your right arm and bring your forehead to the floor. Just stay for a moment. Good. Return and switch your side. Wonderful. Bring it back. Now from tabletop, step your right leg to 1 o'clock. Move your left knee a bit back. Option one, you settle in, drop your head, just keep breathing here. Make sure you untuck your toes. If you want to ground your forearms, do it now. As another option. Drop your head. Good. Bring it back. Switch to side. A few moments just allowing to attune. And even if you feel uncomfortable sensations, try to still be there. As long as it is not painful, it is fine. Return. Now we continue to move to Sphinx pose. Bring your elbows underneath the shoulders or slightly move them forward as you want. Depends on your own sensation. Now drop the shoulders, drop your head. The art of Yin Yoga is to allow it to happen. The art of allowing, the art of non-resistance.
There is always a deeper dimension where you can let go to. Now with your left arm, bring it to the side. Find stability with the right arm, hand, and roll to the side. Bring your right leg up. Now gently place your hand. As well here, invite ease and effortlessness into your practice. Gently transition. Right arm. Left leg. You can always calibrate a little bit and then try not moving at all. Gently release back through the belly, push into top four and bring both of your blocks. If you don't have blocks, you can do it as well without, but it's just more releasing with blocks. Place them, place your hands, hold your knees back and drop the forehead. Now just relax. Continue breathing. Return. Bring your block, one block to the side, and now straddle. Straddle is a great option and our first forward fold. Place a block, ground your forehead, relax. Always attuning to the subtle sensations. Brighten up your awareness. And let go of what is not serving you. remove the block. Now we transition to our spine. We have a very yummy child's pose, a happy baby pose. I call it happy baby bliss. You take your ankles, your feet, and you drop the heels to the bottom. Knees, shoulder blades relax. Then you move your head a few times from side to side. Now, just relax deeper. Find stillness. Not moving at all. Soft lips. And find a deep sense of accepting, deep sense of allowing and opening. One more time, deeply, deeply inhale and sigh it out. Now take your right arm and hug your hamstrings all the way, both of them. Gently, carefully twist to the right side. Then you're gazing and your arm is opening to the left. Wherever you place your arm is fine, just make sure you can relax. Switch. Left arm under the hamstrings. Hug yourself. Twist. And relax. Falling back to bliss. Take another full inhale and exhale. Now bring it back to the spine. Organize yourself, bring your feet and your hands up and shake them out gently. Opening the hands, closing and rocking. And then shavasana. Ah. moments, embrace total beingness, effortless joy. And you feel the connection to the deeper self all over. Remembering that Yin Yoga is a love declaration to yourself. One more time, embrace the art of non-resistance to what is, and find deep acceptance. Keep breathing deeper and move your toes and fingertips. Smile bright, bright. If you want, extend your arms over your head. And then pull your knees in and shift to the side. You're ready, get back to a seated position. Closing the practice through the power of meditation. A moment of stillness and bliss. A moment of pure alignment.